Hello and welcome to another installment of Pediatrics Lectures. In this installment, we talk about Denver Development Screening Test, which is a validated tool to assess any aberrations in development in children aged between 0 to 6 years of age. This DDST requires a little bit of training to correctly administer it, and there are in total 125 test items across the four domains of gross motor, fine motor, adaptive, language, personal, social. Now the testing typically contains items such as a doll, a rattle with a narrow handle, cubes 1 inch and 10 in number, colored ones, then a cup, plastic cup with a handle, raisins, a clear glass bottle with a opening 5 by 8 inch in diameter, a pom-pom with 4 inch diameter, then you have a bell, a ball, and finally a red colored crayon. Not part of the kit, but you also need a white testing paper. So these are the test materials that will be definitely required. Now, how do you administer the test? And this is the test form. For the convenience of it, we have broken down the test form into two slides. And as you see on the top of it, there is the age line and towards left, the domains. Now, typically each test item will have a box with shaded area and unshaded one. The unshaded area is between 0 to 75th percentile, and the shaded area is between 75th to 90th percentile. Some of these boxes will have R written on it, which means that it is a reporting item and you need to ask the parents for its performance by child. And few of them may have asterisks, which means that you need to look at the test form to correctly administer it. Right. Now the second part of the form, and again on the left side you can see the different domains. On bottom you see the age, and I'll draw your attention towards the right corner, which says the test behavior. It just tells us about the subjective nature of behavior while the testing was being performed, in terms of whether the behavior was typical or not, what was the compliance, what was the attention span, what was the fearfulness, and what was the interest in surroundings. Now moving on, how do you calculate age? And let's say you're doing the testing on 30th July 2017, on a child was born on 31st December 2015, then a very elementary maths will tell you that the child's age is 1 year, 6 months and 29 days. Now let's assume this child was premature and was born at 33 weeks of gestation. And that gives you a prematurity of 7 weeks, that is 40 weeks minus 33 weeks, so 7 weeks premature. And if you subtract this prematurity, you'll find that the adjusted age becomes 1 year, 5 months and 26 days. Now, this correction should be done on all children who are born more than 2 weeks premature, and this correction should be continued till that particular child attains an age of 2 years. Once you have calculated the age, it's time to plot it, and you should plot it without rounding off. So in this example, as close as possible to the 18 month line, right? So once you have plotted the age line, you should start administering the test across different domains, beginning from items completely towards the left of the age line, and you move towards the right of the age line till you document consecutive failures in particular domain. Now, how do you score it? So successful performance or report of successful performance will mean that that item is a pass score. However, if the child is not able to successfully perform or caregiver does not report its performance by the child, then you brand it as fail. There may be certain items which the child may not have had opportunity to perform due to restrictions or any other reason, and these are no opportunity scores. And if the child refuses to perform an item continuously, then you brand it as refusal. However, this score is not applicable on reporting items. Now, what are the items? So if you have item which is completed to the right of age line, then and the child is able to perform it, then it's an advanced item. On the other hand, if the child fails or refuses to perform an item completely on the right of age line, or if the child passes, fails or refuses an item in which the age line is crossing between 25th to 75th percentile line, then these items are normal items. Both advanced and normal items are not used in interpretation of the test. This is where a child fails or refuses with the age line crossing between 75th to 95th percentile, and this item is a caution item. And if the child fails or refuses an item completely to the left of the age line, then it's a delayed item. Again, no opportunity items are those in which the child is never had an opportunity to perform it due to restrictions or any other reasons, and there are no opportunity items. Moving on to interpretation. And if a child has maximum of one caution and no delays, then it should be interpreted as normal. And if there are more than two cautions or more than one delay, then the interpretation becomes suspect. Right, and if the refusal scores are more than 2 on an item in which the age line is cutting between 75th to 90th percentile, or more than 1 refusal on an item completely to the left of age line, then you should interpret it as untestable. Right, so these are the interpretation of the test. Now how do you make of it? So once you have given a Denver to the child and interpreted it as normal, then you need to just follow. However, if your interpretation is suspect or untestable, then you need to rescreen after 2 weeks. And if again on rescreening the interpretation remains suspect or untestable, you need to refer the child for definitive developmental pediatrics evaluation and definitive tools for assessment of developmental delay. Right? That is all about Denver screening.